Welcome to the Golden Spike Tower and Visitor Center, a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to take in the panoramic view of Union Pacific's Bailey Yard, the world's largest rail yard from our 8-story tower. The Golden Spike Tower and Visitor Center, more trains than you can keep track of.
The interesting thing about North Platte, especially for the railroad, is historically, here in North Platte, it was a natural fit for a stop-off place, and that was way even before the railroad. Settlers going east coast, west coast, using the various trails, would use North Platte as a stopover. So when Grenville Dodge was surveying the railroad for Union Pacific, he could foresee the future of a rail yard being here because it was a midpoint for Union Pacific. In other words, trains going from Chicago to Salt Lake City, North Platte was in the middle. For trains going from Denver to Omaha, North Platte was in the middle. So it made perfect sense that he could eventually see a rail yard here that would serve the entire railroad.
North Platte was a railroad town before it was North Platte. It was known as Hell on Wheels Town in 1866. And by 1867, mainline operations began complete with a major shop facility for the repair of Union Pacific trains. It remains a major repair facility today.
The Bailey Yard was named after Ed Bailey. Well, Ed Bailey was the president of the Union Pacific from 1965 to 1971. And a lot of people wonder why it was named after Bailey, because Mr. Bailey had a lot of vision in mind. He wanted to make sure the railroad functioned and made sure it was going to go. This is the world's largest classification yard. It's 8 miles long, approximately a mile and a half to 2 miles wide, and it goes 24/7.
Bailey Yard is made up of about 2,500 employees. We run approximately 150 trains a day through here. That's broken down by 60 manifests, 70 coal, and then you have your auto, intermodal, grain, and ore. We process about 10,000 cars a day through the yard. We service about 300 locomotives a day. The two hump yards hump about 1,500 cars each a day. The two hump yards is a key component. The other is the run-through operation, you know, how we process these trains through here quickly. Some of our trainings actually came from NASCAR pit crews of how well we can process these things through here as quick as we can, and how we work together as a team with different departments on trains.
You have 36 loaded coal trains going east every day and 36 empties going west. You average about and a regular freight train will have 138 cars on it. Through the widest part of the yard, there's 301 sets of rails out there. That's enough track to make another main line from here to Omaha or to Cheyenne.
Union Pacific has been the lifeblood of North Platte since it was organized as a city in 1874, 8 years after General Dodge platted Union Pacific's rail yard on this very site. It's also been the lifeblood of thousands of employees. First, second, and third generations have relied on the railroad to support their families. Dale Jurgensen was just one. He began with Union Pacific in 1940. He was a conductor.
Well, it wasn't anything like the conductors that were here when I first come out. The deep conductors, when you first had that, they really grouchy, crabby old men. But when by the time I got there, that's all pretty well changed. It was a little bit more like riding down the highway in your auto. We had the fireman, the engineer, and the brakeman. We all had to check our orders to see if they were right. It was a fun job when we were there. We had a good time. I enjoyed it. We had to retire at age 70, and there were lots of them that didn't want to have to retire at age 70. They preferred to keep working. It not only was their job, it was their life.
Many people's only exposure to trains is waiting for them at a railroad crossing. We see the train engine or locomotive, and oftentimes we count the cars to pass the time. But that big locomotive, now that's something special.
Locomotives in our industry, they're kind of interesting because everyone thinks that it's the diesel engine that's actually powering the locomotive. The best way to describe how a locomotive works is it's much like a model train set. The locomotive actually runs on electricity. The diesel engine turns a huge electric generator, creates electricity, and the engineer, he adjusts the amount of voltage going to the electric motors that are connected to the wheel. in different areas across our railroad, we have diesel repair facilities. Now here at Bailey Yard is one of our largest. We have electricians, we have mechanics that work on the various parts that make up these locomotives. So here they will take a diesel engine apart when it's time for an overhaul. You have electricians that work on the electrical generators. The mechanics here are able to change the very heavy components of a diesel electric engine that we use on the railroad today.
At Bailey Yard, they have two hump yards or elevated mounds that they utilize to sort rail cars. Each car is released from the train down the hump. As the car proceeds downward, retarders slow the car to the perfect speed to couple with the train taking it to its final destination.
Well, we have two different hump yards inside the yard, two different types. One we refer to as an inline yard and one that's more of a side-by-side. The humps themselves are made up of a receiving yard and a departure yard. The bowl tracks is really the tracks where the cars are actually classified. Each bowl track has a specific destination. So one track may be for Little Rock, one may be for Parsons, one may be for Kansas City. And so as those cars are humped into the bowl tracks, that's kind of the term classification. We kind of get them all in the tracks that they go in so that they can meet their outbound schedules to make destination.
And there you have it, a brief glimpse of what you'll see from atop the Golden Spike Tower. Proceed to the elevators and press floor 7 for the open air platform, or floor 8 for the enclosed viewing area. The Golden Spike Tower and Visitor Center. More trains than you can keep track of.